I'm absolutely delighted now to be joined by Dr. Philip Gorlick. Dr. Gorlick, welcome.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here. A wonderful day in San Diego.
Can't beat the sunshine.
Absolutely, especially when you're from Western Michigan.
Now, Dr. Gorlick, tell us a little bit about some of the more recent research you've been involved with.
Well, thank you. We've been involved in a number of interesting projects. One of them is in the U.S. DIAS Clinical Coordinating Center. DIAS is the Desmodoplase and Acute Ischemic Stroke Project. So I and Dilip Pandey, my colleague, have been in charge of coordinating the clinical activities for the trial. We set up a hub and spoke model in the major regions in the U.S. We ended up recruiting close to 80 to 100 hospitals within this hub spoke system. We had thought leaders from major university centers running the hubs in their regions, and we're pleased to say that the project is moving along, and we have about 170 more patients to recruit for the U.S. DIAS-4 project. So we've been working very hard to get recruitment up and see what we can do to get this trial finished. DIAS-3, its sister trial, has just finished in Europe and in Asia, so we eagerly await those results. So that's one project we've been doing. Another project we've been doing is been funded by the World Federation of Neurology and the World Stroke Organization, and that's to set up a prototypic registry to look at the availability of diagnostic and treatment opportunities for people in developing areas. So we have a great website that we've developed with all of the tools and questions that need to be answered. We've finished the pilot phase of the project in places such as Nigeria, Peru, Georgia of the old Soviet Union, and some other countries. We even went into India and had a massive response from India. And so we're in the process of collating all the information and putting a publication together. Another project that we've been very interested in has to do with vascular cognitive impairment. And my colleague, Dr. David Nyenhuis, and I have developed a protocol for a novel blood pressure lowering agent. And we're waiting to hear from the Novartis company if this might be approved to look at early safety and efficacy.
When it comes to, you're involved with a lot of things at the moment. When it comes to preventing stroke prevention in terms of research, is there a big difference between stroke prevention in the U.S. and in developing countries, the ones that you were talking about?
Glad that you asked the question, because we have some very interesting findings from our availability of diagnostic and treatment opportunities in these countries. What we are learning is that many of these countries have very finely trained, excellent vascular neurologists. And the problem is not at the physician end necessarily, but it's at the systems end. Many of these systems do not have the resources that they need to move their prevention efforts forward. And so as we've been probing them about what do you need, is it slide sets for education? No, that's not what they need. What they need are resources. They need tissue plasminogen activator for acute stroke treatment. They need more availability to antihypertensive drugs, lipid lowering drugs, and other stroke preventatives.
Let's talk a little bit about this conference right now. One of the things you're doing this week is moderating the Junior Investigator. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, well, the American Heart Association has put together a number of activities for our junior colleagues. So these are really nice opportunities for them. One of them is an abstract presentation that they will give to an expert, experienced, seasoned group of clinical scientists and basic scientists, and then they will get feedback from these folks at this particular session that will take place this afternoon. So you're putting your reputation out on the line as a junior investigator, you're developing a protocol, and then you're taking it to the experts for feedback. So that's one of the very popular activities for our junior investigators. In addition, there's also going to be a pairing tomorrow of junior investigators with experts in various areas of stroke, prevention, acute treatment, clinical trialism, and so on. And we will get to meet with the different junior investigators. They'll be paired with us. We'll get to do some mentoring sessions and begin to establish relationships with them that could be lifelong.
Dr. Gorlick, we could go on, but we've run out of time. But thank you very much indeed for talking to us today. We really appreciate it and hope you make the most out of San Diego. So thank you.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you, sir.